Expectation versus reality. How big will Bleach do? Will people lose their minds like everybody says online that it will? Will it break servers of streaming platforms? That's what we're going to be talking about today's video. Today with me, I have, as you already know from previous videos, Roe.
Hey guys, should be a fun discussion.
And today I brought Roe with me because he is going to basically fact check anything wrong that I say or possibly add extra context in today's discussion, because I feel like a lot of us as Bleach fans are going to have a high expectation of what Bleach will do and compare it to things such as like Demon Slayer, My Hero, or, you know, even something as big as One Piece, surprisingly not. So that's what we're going to be discussing about today, and that is going to be seasonal versus long running, its competition, how much action and content will be added in, and also discussing about the state of maybe Piro a little bit into that mix as well. But before we proceed, this video is again sponsored by Tokyo Treat and Sakura Co., a monthly Japanese snack subscription box. Tokyo Treat and Sakura Co. is a product that I've had for 2 months now and has really allowed me to enjoy a variety of goods that I wouldn't really get here in the UK. Tokyo Treat is a monthly Japanese subscription box full of the latest exclusive and seasonal snacks, such as Japanese Kit Kats, drinks, and ramen. While Sakura Co. on the other hand is full of authentic artisan snacks with little surprises like snack bowls and chopsticks, as well as the usual tea-related goods. These boxes come with many delicious choices, and each box has a new theme every month, so you'll certainly find their service to be a breath of fresh air every time. Their mission is to share Japanese culture to the world and allow everyone the opportunity to enjoy pop Japanese snacks. So Tokyo Treat would be your go-to. However, if you want more of a traditional Japanese treat, you can go and enjoy Sakura Co. instead. As someone that has both, I generally love what they have to offer here. There is also a booklet in each box too, so anyone worrying about ingredients or genuinely hesitant on what they're eating, then you all have that information provided for you in this booklet. But, you know, where's the fun in that, right? Live life on the risk. But please be sure to check them out. I really generally highly recommend them, and there is a lot of tasty stuff to explore. And I've really been enjoying these with family members too. Do you want a discount? Of course you do. Use code JAMESH04 to get $5 off your first Sakura Co. or Tokyo Treat box today. That's JAMESH04, and let me know what your favourite snack is. That being said, thanks Tokyo Treat and Sakura Co. again, but let's get back to the video. Let's talk about seasonal versus long running, because I think everyone has this expectation about how it's going to look in comparison to seasonal shows that are going to be airing on that same month or previous shows in the past. Will it have a big boom like Jujutsu Kaisen, or will it have a big boom like Demon Slayer, even though those were seasonal? And, you know, I kind of wanted to ask you if you can kind of give a little bit of context in regards to long running versus seasonal, because if you guys don't know, Bleach started production in January, so that gives us at least a good 10 months of production before it even airs. And, you know, obviously it's still going to be in production way after that anyway. So, you know, but before anything else, a good 10 months is, to me, it's good. So, you know, in your experience, Roe, can you elaborate on, is 10 months enough for long running?
10 months is, I'd say that's pretty good for a long running show. However, there is no perfect scenario here. They could have used a year, but I think that 10 months is a lot better than any of Hero's recent shows like Boruto or Black Clover had. Black Clover started production just 3 months before the first episode aired, and the results of that have been pretty telling for the Black Clover anime.
And I think that's like a little bit of an issue as well with some people, is that we have nothing really to compare Bleach's production schedule from other Piro shows currently going at the moment, because again, Black Clover and Boruto, sure, they have their occasional episodes where they, you know, look good, but, you know, 90%, I'd even argue 70% of the time, it's kind of mediocre in a sense. So I think people's expectations of, or their worries of what Bleach will be, is clearly understandable. But I also think because of the name Bleach and its value that the name holds, as well as having such a large pre-production, which we've spoke about in the past and that we've reported on as well, and having a 10-month production is more than obviously Boruto and Black Clovers. So are you yourself confident that it's enough, or, you know, what kind of things worry you about that number or that time of production?
So in the case of long running shows, in the beginning everything might seem to be going really well, but already after, let's say, 20 weeks, you're going to have the production time catch up to you pretty quickly. With shows such as Black Clover, which had a very short one, that was pretty telling when the quality of the episodes started getting very inconsistent and there was a lot of outsourced episodes. In the case of Bleach, just to keep our expectations in check, we're definitely going to have many outsourced episodes. However, that does not necessarily mean the quality of them will be bad. With 10 months to go off, they've had a lot of time to work on this, to do the first couple episodes, so we probably won't see too much outsourcing until later on when they need to use it to get things flowing.
So in regards to the long running aspect, I think it's safe to say we've got the better end of the stick of Pierrot's, you know, track record as of recently. So how can we compare it to seasonal, right? Because people, especially new generation anime fans or people that haven't really been exposed to Bleach, are probably going to be like, okay, like Bleach is like this big name that everyone's hyped about. I'm going to go in watching this with a Jujutsu Kaisen mentality or a Demon Slayer mentality. Or even older fans are feeling maybe they feel they might be entitled to that level of quality, which again, we've waited 10 years. I don't blame you and I'm all for it as well. Do you think because Bleach is a long running and because it's had 10 months of production and it's not seasonal, do you think it has the potential to even get to that level of quality of Demon Slayer or Jujutsu Kaisen? Or do you think we should lower those expectations, and to which degree do you think we should lower those expectations?
In the case of this, I think it's important that we consider the difference between quality and popularity, because of course Bleach is going to have somewhat of a big popularity boost when it returns this October, but we should not expect the anime to look as consistently high quality as, for example, Chainsaw Man might, and definitely not as consistent and high quality as Demon Slayer, because there is a big difference between a long-running show and a seasonal one.
So can you elaborate on what fans are to expect when it comes to those two shows in particular, like Jujutsu Kaisen and Demon Slayer? And by what I mean by that is, will we get anything like close to that level of quality or animation? Do you think it's possible that Bleach has the potential with the pre-production and it's got the production time that it's had? Can it have those levels of which break the internet, such as like Jujutsu Kaisen's peaks or Demon Slayer's peaks? Can Bleach match up to that in like a Unohana versus Kenpachi or a Ichigo versus Kurage? Or do you think we can get to that consistency and even reach those peaks? Do you think that's possible considering our timeline?
I think it's entirely possible that we might have those same insane peaks. However, I think when it comes to long-running anime, I think it's more so the worry about the consistency of these peaks. Because with this 10 months buffer, at least they have a lot of time to try to keep this consistency in check, and they'll have time to work on these like big explosive productions with these high peaks, and we'll probably have the chance to see a lot of really good animation during the run of Bleach.
And I think it's good as well that the story is in fact done, because at least the director can actually see what certain scenes need to have the most staff on or the most resource on, right? So he's not going to say, hey, I'm going to have like 20 animators work on this scene of Ichigo eating bread. I'm going to put 20 animators on this fight with Kenpachi versus Unohana or Iwachi versus Yamamoto. So I like that aspect, because we're not in a real worry of trying to keep away from content from catching up, but instead we've got a whole storyboard, not you know, figurative, not literally, but like we have a whole storyboard in mind of which the director knows where he wants to place things. So in that regard, I have a little bit more hope in regards to those peaks and those highs. I don't know if you feel the same way though.
I do feel the same way, and I think also this is where outsourcing can really help this long-running production, because with Bleach, A Thousand Year Blood War, you'll have a lot of action going on throughout the entire long-running show, right? However, there will be certain moments that will require more effort than others. And in this case, I think that outsourcing can help to buffer between like these high peaks that we're talking about, right? That they'll have some time to produce those amazing episodes.
I mean, it's even cooler as well that Kubo is adding content, and I need to stop seeing, you know, respectfully, comments and even tweets saying, is Kubo gonna add more content? Is Bleach gonna have more elaboration on things? This has been confirmed that there is going to be added content. To what degree, we do not know, but I feel like that's even better as well, because they can pad things out, pad episodes out, like, because I know that Bleach is like fight to fight to fight to fight. So it's good to have like little buffers here and there. And if that's like elaborating on a certain scene or adding extra content, to give that to the outsourced people to do while the main studio does like a massive fight is really cool as well, because you can have some really good choreography, because again, there's so many fights happening in Bleach, is that you don't get like 3 fights in one episode and you get them stretched out over maybe 3 instead because of those buffers. So I think that that's good as well, because you're not putting all your resources and manpower into these 3 fights.
I think that the amount of action that we're talking about here is one of the largest issues with this production.
I agree, yeah.
Because doing so many fight scenes in a long-running show is going to be extremely taxing on the staff. And in regards to what you said about Kubo adding content, I think that's a very good solution to this. With Taguchi, the director, he also did Twin Star Exorcist, which had a lot of anime original content. However, this doesn't necessarily relate directly to this Bleach anime, right? It also leads into the topic of who is going to do this Bleach anime. Is it the people that did Black Clover, or is it like a separate team? We do not know the details on this now, so it's largely speculation. But the Black Clover team seems to be busy with the Black Clover movie, so we shouldn't really be saying anything for certain right now.
So in regards to talking about seasonal versus long running, to talk about, you know, what it means to have a 10-month production and how intense fight scenes will be, and that's really, to be honest, besides character designs and the amount of action scenes in such a condensed manner, those two are the only issues with Bleach's anime, realistically, right, is character designs and fights, because as Kubo's character designs are so intricate, and which again, I always think as well, if you see some off-model stuff, if you see some things you don't like, it's probably going to get fixed in Blu-rays anyway, so it's not all doom and gloom if you happen to see those things. Outsourcing shouldn't be a problem, again, extra added content, as well as, you know, giving them more of the slow moments while the studio works on more of the action-heavy moments, because, again, the storyboard is most slightly a lot better than most shonen series because, you know, it's finished, right? So they have a finished product to play with. I guess to end off this video, because I think this is what everybody kind of wants to know, right? In regards to Bleach coming out in October, can it be up there with Chainsaw Man? Can it fight it off? Do you think it will fail on release? Do you think it will meet expectations? Do you think it will blow people's minds off? And do you think it will be consistent? And if it does test that time of that 2-core Chainsaw Man, do you think it can be on a level of which people who like Demon Slayer be like, oh, okay, well, maybe there is another show that might be on the same level as us in terms of like our highest peaks? In conclusion, do you believe that Bleach will in fact be good? And will it meet expectations?
I think that overall, the Bleach anime will be a pretty good project. However, I do think it's very important that we lower our expectations to the fact that it is a long-running show and not a seasonal. I think that's one of the most important things we can do right now, because I think that in the beginning, it'll definitely come in with a bang, and I think that the quality of the episodes will be consistent in the beginning. However, as the series progresses, I think there will be more of an inconsistent level of quality, but I don't think that the anime will have that many low points as, for example, Black Clover, because of the time they have had to make this production work. And I think they're gonna work their hardest to deliver something that will really give the Bleach fans something to look forward to.
And I think another thing to add on top of that too is that as Bleach goes on and continues production, even when the episodes are airing, there is no shortage of animators, veteran animators, popular animators that really want to work on Bleach. In terms of like outsourcing or in terms of getting staff, they have no shortage in it, and that kind of fills me with a little bit of a hope as well. So I don't have that much of a worry for Bleach. Sure, there might be an episode here and there, like Haikyuu, for example. It had like two bad episodes which got again fixed in Blu-rays, so I'm not all doom and gloom with it. I just hope that the expectations from the fans, because it is a long running and isn't seasonal, don't expect like peak every single episode, and understand that like it will just be better than I personally think it will just be better than your average long running, right? Or better than what we've been conditioned to as of recently. Maybe somewhere on the lines of One Piece. I would like to hope so. Can we expect something like One Piece, or maybe not?
I don't think it'll have the chance of maintaining One Piece's highest peaks. That is somewhat of a miracle on its own. However, I'm not excluding the chances of getting those kinds of peaks in Bleach as well.
So you've heard two different opinions about this, and hopefully you've gotten some more context with what's going on behind the scenes of the production and more of the logistical sides of it as well. I just want you guys to take away from this video that maybe, you know, keep base to reality, and then, you know, if something exceeds your expectations, you know, maybe not saying keep a low expectation, but just a neutral expectation. Whatever is better than that is going to be enjoyable for all of us. But I wouldn't say put all your eggs in one basket for like Demon Slayer quality or Jujutsu Kaisen type quality, because again, it's long running and it's not seasonal. So I'm hoping for nothing but consistency and then peaks where the peaks need to be. But with that being said, Roy, thank you for coming through as always. Show some love to him in the comment section down below. And of course, hit that subscribe. And I'm going to catch more focus like you guys, of course, have this fine. I've been Hansen. As always, people, peace out.